You touched upon the issue of kind of protection innovation.
It is widely recognized that China has become a leading force in digital economy. Last year, our digital economy accounted for 30% and with a growth rate of 20.9%, a rapid growth. Encouraging innovation of digital economy and adopts a prudent yet accommodating regulatory approach to foster sound policy environment for digital economy. But by prudent regulation, the government needs to manage potential risks and avoid major threats. So the development of digital economy itself may generate unbalanced results, including the digital.
Very much. Now let me hand over to Carolyn. This is my favorite topic, by the way, because it's hugely controversial. and particularly a hot topic in Europe is approaching this issue. Maybe elaborate a bit more on what your bureau do as well in terms of using technology for purposes.
It's growing by 25 to 30% per year, and it's contributing. In 2013, we issued a memorandum circular that defines the taxes, that outlines, it's just a payment and service provision. So those are items that are taxable. So all income are taxable. But we did not come up, implemented. The recently passed comprehensive tax reform, package one, we call it the Bureau of Internal Revenue, to implement e-receipting and e-invoicing. Currently, it covers what we call commerce and training, upskilling their employees, you know, for preparation.
The value chain players. What we use, like for example, in 2005, we already accepted the mobile money as for payment. Because e-payment in the Philippines usually is on remittances for, you know, so many Filipino overseas work. But when it comes to paying taxes, people still pay over the counter. Even though the collection is 85% e-payment, the number of transactions before was just around 5%. But with the use of, we have this year, it's around, it's more than 19%. So we really think that even us, the tax agency, consultation involving the young people. Recently, we launched a hack tax that is banks to be able to learn how they transform. We had one bank in the Philippines. It's like the Philippines, like we watch and learn. So those are the collaborations that we are doing right now, and we hope to do it.
Thank you very much. And let's, firstly, we have the perfect split in two ways on this panel, both in terms of gender, three women, three men. Chandra, I'm very keen to know kind of what role do you see for a large company like this?
And if you look into the areas where I think we see the transformation is happening, on the customer side, there's a huge change in behavior that is very much driven by mobile, the internet penetration in Thailand. So mobile is a very big trigger of it. So we as connected now, so that changes also the way you produce. You have to better understand customers and their needs. So it's much more analytics driven. So a lot changes on the customer front and working on it. And the third for me is, I think, also regarding infrastructure. If I look just at our company, we have been building networks, we have been...
Gracias. เ ไม่ใช่เวลาอะไรเนี่ยหรือว่าทำให้เวลาเหรอมันไม่ใช่เวลาที่เด็กคอร์ดว่าไหนเนี่ย16 12ก็ได้เออมันอยู่กับที่จริงๆเลยอันนี้เลข5 7 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 มันจะพิบคือไม่มันจะพิบเพราะมันจะยากเป็นสองไฟหนึ่งโอเค